Do you pay your vendors before you receive the product or service that you're paying for? Well, I'm going to show you how to record any kind of advance payment, prepayment, job deposit, or down payment if you're using QuickBooks Online. Now, the vendor records must show and explain this clearly so that it can be clear to both us and the vendor what future services are owed to us and how much. Now, the method you're about to see will work perfectly and allow your vendor reports to explain everything. But we should still take a moment to discuss the effect of a vendor prepayment or down payment in your chart of accounts and how it will change your trial balance. Well, we know if we pay from our bank account for the advanced down payment or prepayment, we know already cash in bank will go down. However, what would be the other account that would change in order to keep the trial balance balanced? And of course, we know cash in bank will go down. But should the other account involved in the transaction be the expense that we're paying for? The answer is no. Unfortunately, the rules of accounting say that you cannot record an expense until you've actually expended the value of what you paid for. So until you got what you paid for, you cannot record it in the expense account. So what's the other account that changes when cash in bank goes down? The answer is accounts payable. You see, accounts payable represents what we owe the vendor. And obviously, if we're paying them, we owe them a different amount at the moment that we pay. Now, normally, we get the service before we pay. So a positive number in accounts payable means that's an amount that we owe them. But if we pay before we get the service, they owe to us. And QuickBooks Online will record a negative number both in the vendor records and in the accounts payable account in the chart of accounts to represent the idea or the fact that they now owe us a certain amount in future services. And that's why I call the method of recording job deposits to vendors the check to accounts payable method. And this method will work beautifully for you if you just carefully follow these steps. First, make sure you're recording this prepayment or job deposit either in the expense window or the check window. Now, of course, once you're here, you're going to put the vendor name in the vendor field for whichever vendor you're giving this advance payment to. But the most important field in this particular case is the category field for account category. Again, you will not put the expense that you're paying for. You will instead, if you're paying in advance, put accounts payable. Then, after putting all the other fields of data in the transaction, you then click Save and Close and double check to make sure that it was recorded as a negative number in your accounts payable records. Then the next step happens on the day that you actually get the service. When you get the service, the vendor should give you a paid bill, but whatever document you get that you sign that proves that you got the service, that's the source document for you to record a bill in the vendor records for the vendor that you paid in advance. You would then record that bill the same way you record any other bill that you get from a vendor. The difference is when you finish recording the bill, you have to immediately do the very last step. The very last step is to open the Pay Bills window and make sure that you apply the bill that you just recorded to the advanced payment that you had recorded with a check or an expense at the beginning of the process. Once you apply them together in the Pay Bills window, they should both disappear and neither of them should remain on the unpaid bills report. So let's do an example. Let's imagine it's April 20 and we paid a new vendor Risa's Repair Ranch, and we paid her to fix our equipment. We gave her check number 8795 for $500, and she agreed to fix our equipment before May 31, and she promised to contact us when she is finished. Should we record repair expense today, April 20? The answer is no. It is no because we have not yet received the repair that we paid for. We will instead put accounts payable.
From the top left, we click New, Check. And the date is April 20 of 2025. Now we have a new vendor that we already learned how we can add a vendor on the fly. Or all we have to do is click Add New, and let's just put in only the name, and if you want, you can come back and put in the address and other information the way we learned in prior videos. And we push Tab, and in a real situation, we would put the other information, but for now, just click Save, and now we have the vendor. Now the amount it says is $500, and the check number we actually paid her 8795, so maybe we're using a different checkbook. Now, the most important thing is the category here. The most important thing is the account that you choose from the list.
And the most important field when filling out this check is this field right here. The category field needs to be accounts payable.
And the reason the account is accounts payable is because it simply decreases the vendor's balance and makes it negative. Because all that happened is we paid the vendor and they owe us the money. So both cash and accounts payable goes down. So we type in ACC and it's accounts payable. Save and close. And when we take a look at the vendor reports, we can click Reports. And the most important one is the Unpaid Bill Report. And when we check the Unpaid Bill Report for the brand new vendor that we have, Risa's Repair Ranch, Risa now has a negative balance in accounts payable, which means she owes us for the future service.
So now let's imagine it's April 21. And Risa returned our equipment completely repaired and as good as new. What do we record now on April 21?
So now we have to enter the bill normally.
All we have to do is use the Enter Bill window and record all the information about the transaction of receiving the service on the day we receive the service. Sometimes the vendor makes it easy by giving us a paid bill with all the information we need to record right into the bill's window, and then everything will work out perfectly.
Just click New, Bill, and we got the bill on the day that she finished, the next day, the 21st, from Risa's Repair Ranch. Now, of course, the bill would have a bill number and so forth. But the amount of the bill we know is the $500. Okay, now this is the moment that we have the repair expense. We have the repair expense when we actually got the repair. So we enter the bill normally whether we paid before or after the service. And when we click Save and Close, we can come back to the unpaid bill report and see Risa has a check that we sent her that made the balance negative and a bill that increased it and made it positive.
But you may notice that Risa's net balance is zero. That's because right now, neither we owe her nor she owes us. So she should not be on the unpaid bills report at all. How do we wipe her off the unpaid bill report? we take the bill that we recorded and apply it against the prepayment that we originally recorded, and when they wipe each other out, Risa will disappear from the unpaid bill report because her balance will be zero and all the open items will be applied together. The window that you use to do that is the pay bills window.
To do is use our good friend, the pay bills window, just like we learned before. New, pay bills. Now, we want to filter it for all dates, and we want to filter it just for our new friend, Risa's Repair Ranch. So we only have this one bill, and there's no indication of the $500 credit that we should get for the check that we wrote. But remember, when we click inside credit applied, we see that the check gives us $500 of credit that we can apply. So we type in and make sure the payment amount is zero. This is the same as we learned in prior videos when applying credits to pay bills. And now when we click save, we can go back to the unpaid bills report and check the section of Risa. Excuse me.
And now you can see Risa is no longer on the unpaid bill report because she has neither an unpaid bill nor an open credit that needs to be applied. And I'd like to close by stressing that the method you just saw was exactly the correct one. And some people with very low experience or from the old days of computerized accounting when things were not clear, still seem to think that there's another way to record vendor prepayments and down payments. And I'd like to give you a small piece of accounting theory as a gift for watching this video all the way till the end. There is no method of recording vendor down payments and prepayments in any accounting program, no method that allows the general ledger, trial balance, and the chart of accounts to be correct every single moment and have your vendor records and vendor reports also be correct at every single moment. No method in no accounting program. Now, when we eventually receive the service, both sets of records will be correct every moment forever. But between the moment that we paid the job deposit down payment and the moment that we actually receive the service that we're paying for, either the trial balance and the chart of accounts will be temporarily wrong, or the vendor records will be temporarily wrong. And you have to make the right choice. The answer is, on a day-to-day basis, it is more important to make sure that your vendor records are completely accurate to the last detail. You have to manage your relationship with your vendors and reconcile their statement to your records. If that doesn't happen, you might not have the vendors to be able to pay for the service. And for those of us who have experience in accounting, we know that it's normal to have certain balances in your general ledger and chart of accounts be temporarily inaccurate until you're ready to report your financial statements. Of course, right before you report your financial statements, you will make normal accountant adjustments, the type of adjustments that you learned about in accounting school, in order to correct your financial statements and have them accurate with each closing number on the statement date. So exactly which balances in our trial balance are inaccurate between the moment we pay the vendor and the moment we receive the service? Well, you're not really supposed to have a negative balance in accounts payable for any specific vendor. That's because if you look at the total accounts payable balance, it won't really be a reflection of exactly what's owed to all vendors in total. That negative number throws off the amount and it's a little unclear for someone who's looking at the balance sheet. So the proper classification for that amount between the moment that we paid the vendor and the moment that we received the service should be instead recorded into prepaid expenses. For example, if it were UPS that we gave the down payment or deposit to, it would be prepaid delivery expense. If it were the electric company that we gave the down payment or deposit to, it would show up on the financial statements and the balance sheet as prepaid electric expense, and so on. So all you have to do on the day that you report your financial statements is record an adjustment that removes the negative number from accounts payable and puts it instead as a positive number in the proper prepaid expense account. And for those of us who love accounting, we know that credit accounts payable to wipe out the negative and debit the prepaid expense. You would have to do that in the general journal, but that demonstration and more about that topic is really for another video. That means that between the day that we paid and the day that we got the service, somewhere between there, we needed to report our financial statements. So the amount has to be adjusted from between the day that we paid and the day that we report. This amount in here should not be negative accounts payable. It should be reclassified as prepaid expenses. Then once you report your financial statements, you should reverse the entry. So for that rest of the period of time, your accounts payable records will be accurate regarding your relationship with your vendors. And that is the full explanation regarding anything you could possibly need to know about advance payments, prepayments, job deposits, or down payments to any of your vendors. I hope the video helped you, and I hope you will click like and please subscribe to help support the free channel for everyone.